Hello, hello. My name is Caroline and welcome to the Caroline Live Show. If you are online, please say hi. I've already said hi online. Hello, Walter from Germany. Welcome to the show. Anybody else, please do let me know you're on the show. If you have questions, please put it in the chat field and I will try to get to as many questions as I can during this show today. Thank you so much for joining. My name is Caroline and this is Project Ideas with Caroline. Now, before we get started, as we always do, I always want to go over a few housekeeping items. Number one, we do this every Thursday at 3 o'clock my time, 3 o'clock Eastern, 12 Pacific, and I think 8 o'clock Greenwich Mean Time. This is a place of positivity. Things can be really tough right now with the COVID, with the everything that's going on in the world, and we just want to be positive for a few minutes while we share ideas. And number three, please mute your Amazon Echo or watch with a headphones or whatever you need to do, but I will be saying the wake word a lot and I probably will trigger your device if your device is within earshot. And that is part of this show that we're having. Okay, I see a Ranj, R-A-N-J, and I cannot pronounce your last name. Okay, so welcome to the show. All right, we're gonna go ahead and get started right now. I've got a lot of stuff to cover with you guys today. So first of all, Hi, Sam is my friend from Taiwan. All right, so we have a bunch of stuff to cover today. One, updates from last week. I'll give you everything that happened in the last week. And I've got some bad news, good news. So different stuff I'm going to share about stuff from last week. Project ideas. Today I'm going to talk about two different Raspberry Pi projects. Now, one of them doesn't have a tutorial, but it's so awesome that I had to share it. And then the other one does have a full tutorial. And then I'm going to share an Arduino project I thought was really cool. And then we're going to talk about Alexa and cats. Yes, that'll be the Alexa discussion for today. And then, of course, I'll reveal next week's video at the end of the show. All right, so let's get started here. All right, so on Tuesday, I released a new video. It is the Plex Watch Together video. Essentially, if you're familiar with Facebook and there's this watch party you can do on Facebook, essentially you can do the same stuff with your Plex content. So if you have a movie on your server, on your Plex server in your home, you can now share it with your friends and you can all watch it exactly the same time and have a watch together party. And so that's one of the social distancing things that Plex has come out with. It's a new feature. It's experimental, so your results may vary. In my testing, everything worked really great, and it worked perfectly for me. So anyway, just to let you know, I'm going to put that link in the description field right now. And so that way, if you've missed that video and you want to go back and watch that video, you can do that. All right, Ranj says, please upload video maybe sometime. We are don't know. You make live. You, I don't know, teacher, thank you. Okay, I'm not sure what that meant, but okay, thanks, Ranj. All right, next is there was a bonus video that I released last Saturday, and unfortunately, it was a negative review about my new 3D printer, the Tronxy 3D printer. It was a DO1 printer. It does not produce any viable prints whatsoever. And I asked for a refund or a new printer, so they sent me a refund of $10. I spent $414.99 on this printer, and now I'm in process of disputing the charge on PayPal. So we'll see how that goes. I'll let you know. But anyway, if you want to see my Tronxy printer review, and thank you to everybody who commented, watched my video, who shared my video. Thank you, everybody, so that to help other people make good decisions about buying a 3D printer. So definitely would not recommend a Tronxy 3D printer. And but thank you for everybody who commented and watched the video. Okay, so now I have some good news to share with you. And I think some of you watchers already knew this and nobody told me this. So if you'd like to share things, that if you've seen me somewhere and you'd like to tell me that you saw me in a magazine next time, that would be really helpful. Because I did kind of notice that I was getting more views on this show than normally a few weeks ago. And I thought it was because I changed the thumbnail picture or something. I had no idea. No, that was not it. I am in the current edition of the MagPi, the official magazine for Raspberry Pi, and it's this, it's the June edition. It is issue number 94, and I've thrown up a picture here of the table of contents. I've got a nice picture in the table of contents. Thank you so much, MagPi magazine. Thank you so much to the Raspberry Pi folks for featuring me in your magazine. I'm super honored. I'm super thrilled to be in the current edition of the MagPi magazine. I didn't realize this until the magazine actually dropped on May 28th, so 3 weeks, 2 or 3 weeks ago. So it's been a while since this magazine appeared, and then I noticed I had more views on this show. So anybody's watching, thank you so much for reading MagPi and watching my show. And so I didn't realize it until last Friday. I did the interview over a month ago, and they didn't tell me, hey, when it was going to come out or anything. They didn't give me any information. So I just happened to be looking at Twitter, and I'm like, oh, hey, the new MagPi just dropped. And I was kind of like, am I in it? Am I not in it? Nobody said anything. You know, and then I open it and I'm like, oh my gosh, I'm in it. Okay, so I drove to my local micro center to try to buy the magazine. They were sold out. I called the other micro center. They were also sold out. So now I've ordered the magazine online, and hopefully that will come soon. So I'm super thrilled to see myself in print coming up. So if you want to read the issue, I will put a link in the description field here right now. And here is the MagPi issue 94, June 2020. That is the current edition, and you can download the entire thing for free right here. And that's pretty cool. So if you hit download free PDF, you get a PDF, the whole thing. You're not missing anything if you just download the free PDF right here. It doesn't even ask you for your information. It's just a free, you just hit it and it's just going to automatically download. So then here is the download right here. Here is the table of contents. Here's my picture. Yay. And if you click on my picture, it takes you to the article, my interview with the MagPi editor. And these are some photos I provided that has to do with some of the projects that I've done over the years. And of course, you can see all of this on my YouTube channel, as you well, no, I'm sure. So that was super, super exciting this month, getting featured in MagPi. So thank you everybody who's seen it and knows me for it. So I've been a big fan for years now. So it's thrilling to be in the magazine. Okay, next, moving on. Hi, Leonardo. Hi, Caroline. Love your videos. Oh, thank you, Leonardo. All right, next we are going to talk about, we're going to jump right into the Raspberry Pi projects. This is where I just talk about projects I've seen and kind of just recommend projects to you that you can do in your home while social distancing or not social distancing. By the way, all the shelter at home stuff is out in my area. Nobody's sheltering at home anymore. There are no more lockdowns, nothing. So anyway, I saw this project yesterday on, I think, the Raspberry Pi Twitter feed, and I was like, wow, this is the coolest project I've ever seen in my entire life on Raspberry Pi. So it's called a Spotify turntable. I don't think this is an actual record. I don't think it actually plays records. I think what you do is, I think you move the little needle over to the fake record, and it plays your Spotify playlist. Hello, hi. I cannot pronounce these names. I'm so bad at name pronunciation. Hi, Mr. and Mrs. Gowda. Welcome to the show. But I try to acknowledge everybody who's on the show. But anyway, let's see. I'm going to give you a link to the Raspberry Pi Spotify turntable project. Now, this project does not have a tutorial. And I think it's super complicated. That's why it doesn't have a tutorial. But let me show you this. There's a close-up view. And basically, if you look at where the record is, you can see that it's a touchscreen in the middle part, the empty part of that record. And basically, that's how you control your what song you're going to play on your Spotify playlist. So essentially, let me go over to, if you click on that link, it's a Raspberry-powered wedding memories record player. That's what he's calling it. He made it as a wedding gift, well, actually as a 3-year anniversary wedding gift for his sister. And basically, he, you know, this is a carpentry project. And he's got these speakers that he hooked up to his Raspberry Pi. And he made this, even music is a huge deal. That was kind of the theme of their wedding. And basically, it is a Spotify playing, but it looks like an old-time record player, Raspberry Pi project. And it is, I think, one of the coolest projects, if not the coolest project I've ever seen on Raspberry Pi. Here are, you know, kind of the components. So he's got this LCD screen underneath the record, and it's a touchscreen, and that's how you control your Spotify playlist. And he's got some nice speakers here, and so this is kind of the setup, and then he got everything into that little box, and he had a little instruction manual because this was a gift to somebody else who didn't build it, and that is a really cool project in my opinion. But sorry there's no tutorial, but this looks like, they said it took hours or days to do this, so this looks like a pretty hard project to do. I obviously will not be doing this on my channel because I have no carpentry skills, I have no wood saw station, I have no wood, so anyway, I won't be doing this on my channel, but hey, I thought it was really cool to feature. So what do you guys think? I think this is awesome. All right, so that's project number one I'm presenting today. Now let's go to project number two, or actually the segue into project number two for Raspberry Pi and Arduino, is last week, let's go back to the PowerPoint presentation. Okay, last week I announced I'm one of 10 winners in an Element 14 contest. And let me give you the link to the results of that, of said contest. Copy and paste that into the chat field here. Okay, so there were all these entries, and then there was a grand prize winner, and then there were nine other winners. So 10 winners total. And I thought it'd be really cool if I featured the projects from this contest in my YouTube live today. Yes, so your first question is probably, what was the winning project? And that's a great question. We're gonna talk about that first. It's actually an Arduino project. So the contest requirements were, number one, you had to be female in order to enter the contest. They had a contest that was not gender specific, I think 2 years ago or something like that, and they only had one female entry. And so they said this time, and so they had all male entries. So this time around they said that's why it was only open to females. And so I entered, there were all these entries, and let's see, let's move on into the contest page, browser, okay. So this is the online film festival, and here are all the winners, including myself, and the grand prize winner, and let's go to her entry page, and you can see her project was automatic dispenser system. And essentially she hooked up an Arduino to a water pump with a motor, and it spit out water. In the video itself, it's just water. But she said you could use this for hand sanitizer or something else COVID related. Hi, Cristiano Santos from Brazil. All right, thank you for joining the show. So just to kind of give you an idea here on this project. Let's go to camera only. So anyway, for this project, you need a motor. You do need a battery or some sort of power source for the motor itself. And she did this on Arduino. So if you're not familiar with Arduino, this is an Arduino. And then she reveals, of course, all the full code on this in this project here. So she goes through that, and she does have a nice circuit diagram and all of the all of everything. And so this project was really cool because it was a lot of upcycling. She found a really old printer cable she wasn't using anymore, and that is she used a lot of that printer cable, like the wires out of that printer cable. So not the ends of the printer cable, but the wiring from the printer cable. And I think she used a tube because it was a very thick cable as her tube. So anyway, this was a really cool project. I don't know if it's going to play or not, how much y'all are going to see of this project. But anyway, you see her, using an old printer cable, using it as a water tube. She's got a bunch of wires here after she took apart this thing. Then she's got, I think this is like a lipstick case or a lip balm or something, and she cut some holes in it, and that's kind of how she gets the water to kind of flow through. So she's threading everything through this lipstick case, lip balm thing here. And then, yeah, that's her motor, and then she's got a power supply for her motor, and then she's got a very creative way of putting this all together. And then at the end, and then oh yeah, so here's the circuit diagram. 9-volt battery, Arduino, and she's got all that going. And then so she gets like a cup of water and she puts it on top there, and then you wave your hand in front of it or something, and then it spits out water. And that was her project. What do y'all think? Okay, going back. All right, what'd y'all think about that project? Do y'all work with Arduino? Did y'all like Arduino? Is that something interesting for you? Let me know. Okay, so now let's talk about, I know that y'all like to talk about Raspberry Pi, and I always talk about Raspberry Pi in every episode of this show, the Caroline Live Show. So I did want to show you my personal favorite Raspberry Pi entry from this contest. Well, actually one of my favorites, Raspberry Pi project from this contest. And that was the burpee counter. So y'all know I'm into, you know, fitness and exercise. I don't do burpees because they are really hard to do. Oh my gosh. But what this lady did, Georgia Grand, she made a burpee counter, and you can see her, it's an ultrasonic sensor. So this, maybe y'all can see this. This is an ultrasonic sensor. And basically every time it detects movement, there's a counter, there's a little screen, and she is using a Raspberry Pi with this project, and it just visually tells her how many burpees she's done. Anyway, so I thought that was a really cool project. I thought all the projects were really cool, even some of the ones that didn't make it into the top 10, and maybe I will just keep on continuing to feature these projects and giving you kind of my perspective on these projects as we continue on this road of more and more Caroline Live episodes. So anyway, so that is my So I've presented two Raspberry Pi projects and one Arduino project for this week. And then I always present a Alexa project, something we can do with our Alexa. So let me switch back over here. Alexa. All right. So this is really funny. This was kind of suggested to me by Amazon as to something I could do with my Amazon Echo here. And if y'all aren't familiar, I talk about this a lot on my channel. I don't know how familiar you guys are with this, but there's something called Alexa Skills. And basically, like for your phone, there are apps for your phone. You can have an app for your Alexa, and there are developers such as myself who make apps that they're called Alexa Skills for Alexa. Anyway, so this is not one I wrote, but this got quite the reaction from my cat this morning when I tried it out, and it's called Alexa, Find My Cat. Alexa, stop. All right, did y'all hear that? Hopefully y'all could hear that through the microphone. Sam says, really behind the times. What is a burpee? Oh gosh. What is a burpee? It's an exercise that you jump up and do a push-up or a downward dog or something like that, and you jump back up again. They're super hard to do, okay? That's why I do not do burpees. But for very physically fit people, they do burpees, okay? So back to Find My Cat. This got quite the reaction from my cat this morning. I played it, and she started growling at it, and then at one point she hissed at me over these sounds of these cats. I don't know if it just created a lot of distress for her or it was very upsetting to her, so I won't be doing this anymore with my cat, but I thought it was kind of funny that I actually got a reaction out of my cat from an Alexa skill. So there are Alexa skills for cats or for humans who want to trick their cats, and that brings me to a skill I wrote called Open Cat Food. And so I can demo that for you if I haven't done so already. Alexa, open cat food. Alexa, stop.
Thanks for opening a can of cat food. Goodbye.
And basically, this is a recording of myself opening a can of cat food. And sometimes it does get a reaction from my cat, and sometimes she does run into the kitchen and look in her food bowl to see if there is fresh food in her food bowl. I'm bringing this up because, one, you know, we just have this obsession with cats as pets, and there are a lot of very popular cat skills on Alexa, on Amazon Echo. For me, this was an exercise in creating Alexa skills. That is something I do. That's something I do for money. As a consultant, is I put together Alexa skills for clients, and I always have to make an example skill to show a potential client, hey, this is how it works, or this is something that could happen. So I get a lot of questions about international skills, about how Alexa handles different languages. So, you know, first of all, Alexa is not available in every single country in the world. You know, there are certain countries and there are certain languages within those countries that are available. So, for example, in the US, you can have English or Spanish. In Germany, it's German. In Canada, it's English or French you could have. So I started thinking through, hey, how do I make a skill where I can test out the different languages? Unfortunately, I don't know any other languages other than English, and I can't run everything through Google Translate. Google Translate's not perfect. It doesn't understand nuances and everything, and I'm not going to get anything accepted. So in thinking of an exercise where I wanted to launch this skill in every country and in every language, but without learning the language or being able to do something in every language, I thought, hey, wouldn't it be funny if I launched this cat food skill where it's just a sound of an opening of the cat food, and not really a back and forth in a foreign language I don't understand. Could I make a skill that would be accepted in every country? And I did go through this process. I did get this accepted in every country except for Germany. So let me go into the cat food skill. This is my skill. I can give you the URL for my cat food skill right here. And if you look at it, it says see all supported languages, and this skill is available in English, Australia, English, Canada, English, Great Britain, English in India, English, US, French, Canadian, French, France, Hindi, Japanese, Portuguese in Brazil, Spanish in Spain, Spanish in Mexico, and Spanish in the US. And I it was a very interesting exercise in going through every approval process for every country to get the same skill approved. Yes, it does have to be approved every single time for every country, for every language. So each of these languages / country is a separate, everything separated by a comma here is a separate approval. I mean, granted, you put it all in, but you can get approved in the U.S. English and then not get approved in French Canadian, and then it holds up your entire skill. Nothing gets put out into public until everybody approves everything. So the only country that I couldn't do, the only language I couldn't do was Germany. And it wasn't because I couldn't get the skill to work. Obviously, I can get the skill to work in any language. The problem was that in Germany, to say cat food was one word, and Amazon does not allow one word start names, one word invocation names. So my invocation name in this scenario is cat food. Alexa, open cat food. And in Germany, it had to be the German translation, the German word for cat food is a one word, and then they wouldn't approve it because they don't approve one word invocation names. So it never got approved in Germany, but it got approved in Hindi and Japanese. So Japanese was really hard to do. But anyway, I got it approved in every country as an exercise to understand the process of getting a skill approved in every country that is available and in every language. So anyway, that's my thing. By the way, this cat food skill was featured by Mashable. And did they call me? Did they let me know? Did anybody let me know? No. Actually, a friend of mine who happened to be on Mashable one day saw my skill, and here it is, was looking at the Mashable article. Where did my Mashable article? Oh, yes. And saw an article called "These 10 Amazon Alexa Skills Are More Weird Than Useful." And then scrolled down and was like, "Hey, look, it's cat food. Hey, I know the person who wrote cat food. It's Caroline," and sent it to me. And that's how I found out I was on Mashable. Okay. Sam says, "Nothing in Taiwanese, but now my cats are all around me waiting, LOL." Okay, so it works, yay, look at that. All right, so anyway, I just wanted to talk about Alexa skills, one little tidbit about doing Alexa skills in different languages and how it works, and that's something I learned. Okay, so let's go back to the PowerPoint. Y'all don't have a lot of questions for me today. Last week, y'all had a bunch of questions about stuff. So anyway, moving on, this is open cat food in English. Alexa, abre comida para gatos is how you say it in Spanish. Alexa, abre nuestra puerta. My language skills are terrible. That's French, and then Japanese, not even close. I did make this little image to show, hey, I can do stuff in different languages. Oh, so anyway, hope you enjoyed that. If you have any questions, let me know. All right, so last but not least is my project reveal, my video reveal for next week. Do y'all know what my video is going to be for next week? It's going to be a Raspberry Pi status light indicator. And so this, I've shown this on this live show previously. It is a Raspberry Pi, and I'm going to switch over to my browser here and go to my status indicator. So I made this little website. It's a local website. So if you look at it, it says desktop. Okay. And what I can do, hopefully y'all can see this, what I do is I can just change the color of the light on this from this website. Hopefully y'all can see this. Blue, pink, off, random color. So this is green, red, yellow, blue, pink, and off. So hopefully hopefully y'all find that interesting or fun. And this is a Raspberry Pi 0W and a Pi Maroni unicorn hat and a little diffuser. And I will reveal all of the code. I will reveal the whole assembly, everything in my video. And that launches Tuesday, this upcoming Tuesday at noon Eastern, my time. All right. And that is my show this week. So, thank you for watching. Thank you everybody who joined the show this week. And if there are no more questions, I'm going to say goodbye. Thank you, everybody.